pop this up right here. Very good. What the fuck? Okay. All right. Everyone calm down. Gray just fell through the world. Hello, everybody. GrayStillPlays, and we're back with more My Summer Bar Simulator. So, is the toilet looking worse, or is it just me? I feel like it's looking dirtier and dirtier. To be fair, though, we've been pissing into this thing for, like, 50-something episodes? I have no idea. While we're here, let's go ahead and throw on a little bit of topless gun, because you boys know how it is. So there's some things that must happen today. One of the things is I have to go ahead and utilize your guys' recipe for the ultimate Kilju. So the very first thing I have to do is freaking dump this crap all over the floor. There we go. Now we can, if we want to do, we can lick it all off the floor. I don't know if you guys are into that or not. But you guys were saying one yeast, 6 sugar, and that gets you the sweetest, most delicious Kilju that ever was. Now the only problem is I don't know if we have 6 sugars laying around. I know. You'd figure we would. We have everything else laying around this frickin' place. I see a lot of yeast. I'm pretty sure that's yeast. Is that yeast? That is yeast. But I don't see any sugar. How about outside? In the lovely OCD-destroying, soul-blighting mess that we have out here. We got some sausages. Got some pizzas. We got chips. And Lord knows, boys, we got beer. But the one thing that I can clearly see that we don't have is freaking sugar, which means we're going to have to go buy some. Oh, in case you guys didn't see as well. Oh, the other thing that I want to do today, because one of you guys suggested this, is grab the sofa and put the sofa on the train tracks and then go to sleep on the sofa when the train comes. What sort of grand things will happen? I imagine we'll reach a state of unkillability and survive. That's my guess. What time is it here anyway? Oh, we got plenty of time left. It's not even 1 o'clock yet. We should be able to get to the store with no problem. Car's looking a little, I'm not gonna lie, the car looks like shit. But everything should be okay. Oh, do I have some sugar in here? Oh, I think I do. Look, we got a fender in here too. Hold on. Might as well put this over here because you boys know I lose fenders all the time, man. Hold on, we have a sugar right there. Go ahead and toss that over there. Got some additional chips in here as well. Let me get rid of all this here. Hold on. Oh, there's some more things on the floorboard. Oh, it's milk. Yeah, sure. I'll drink a milk. Milk does the body good. You boys know. And not only that, your milk carton also defies gravity. Can any one of you throw a milk carton that far? I've never tried myself. So, there's some updates coming to the game, and that's the other reason that I'm playing today, because as you boys know, there is a superstition that goes along with me playing this game. Whenever I play this game, and it's been a little bit, usually an update comes out, and I'd be very interested to see the update that is going to befall us sometime soon. We've got a couple of cool things coming down the pipeline. For one, we're looking at, what was it? It was going to be a moped, or at least they said potentially a moped. Now that would be freaking sweet. I would love to see a moped in this game because I've died to everything else, so I might as well die to the moped as well. And also, they were saying that you will have the ability to get engine parts finally to fix your own damn engine instead of, hold on, oh, right over here. Instead of having Flattari do everything. Hold on, let me go ahead and put this up. Get out of here. Oh, I didn't put my freaking seatbelt on. Boys know what happens when Gray doesn't use his seatbelt. Hold on. Do we have enough sugar right over here? If we have enough sugar over here, I'm not even going to have to do this crap. Oh, look at this. Look at, no, it's the juice frog. Crap. Oh, God. Come on, man. There's plenty of yeast, plenty of milk, and plenty of freaking sausage. I guess I'll grab one while I'm here. So I found something out very sad today. Well, actually, it was yesterday, but I had to do something about it today. This is a little glimpse into the life of Gray. So if you're still hanging around watching this, you get to know a little bit of something about me. I have some cats, and they're good cats. I love my cats. Cats are fantastic. One of my cats has diabetes. Just found that out. It's very sad. And I don't know why. He's 8 years old. He's a healthy some bitch. Runs all over the place. Good and strong. Got plenty of muscle tone. But one day, he began drinking water. A lot of, well, okay, that sounds terrible. Of course he drinks water, he's a freaking animal. But he began drinking more water than I'm used to. Like a lot of water. And I was like, man, something seems really odd here. Cat's drinking a lot of water. And then he started losing weight. So he was getting pretty skinny and I was like, man, this is damn strange. He eats everything. Guy could eat a half dozen finished sausage. He would be totally, he'd be still hungry. So we took him to the vet and wouldn't you know it, he's got diabetes. So I have to start giving my cat insulin. And I guess it's a lot like anyone else takes insulin. It's human insulin. There's no cat insulin. Well, maybe there is, but they didn't give that to me. They just gave me some human insulin. And insurance does not cover it. So let me tell you how much insulin costs. Costs right around as much as a new Logitech steering wheel and shifter combo. He's a hell of a guy though. He didn't give a rat's ass. I stuck him with the needle and he's like, so? And I was like, damn. Cause I don't know about you boys, but I'm not a big fan of needles. I'm not one of those people that passes out when like I'm getting stuck, but I do very, very reflexively look away from the puncturing of my vascular system. Oh, hey, I think I just found another piece of our car. Hold on here. Let's go ahead and pick this up. We're almost at the store though. I'll tell you, there's pieces everywhere. You keep a close eye. You'll find them. This is how I find all my stuff. Whenever I lose a sledgehammer or whenever I lose a piece of my vehicle, just wandering around a little bit eventually gets me there. How's it going there, scumbag? Ugh. Yes. Thought I'd say hi the old-fashioned way by slamming my vehicle into yours, you dirty whore. Someone said if I drink my pee in front of him, he says something. Hold on, let's find out. Here we go. Let's see what he says. There we go. Yes! Yes! Get that thirst down, boys. Get that thirst down. Hold on, he's not saying anything yet. Peeing up to the sky. Up to the sun. Anything? Anything? Nothing? No? I can't believe this dude's still alive. Oh, crap. Hold on. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. All right. Yep, I remember what happened last time I messed around over here. I got freaking hit by this dude and he killed me. Oh, the bus! Oh, the bus, yes! Oh, man, I was hoping that bus would have taken his ass out. Oh, they're going for a ride together. This is very interesting. Bye. I can't say I've ever seen that before in my life. Hey, Timon, what's up, man? Hey, listen, I need all your sugar. What for? I'm doing a lot of baking. A lot of baking. Let's see here. I used to have a dog. Again, one thing I used to have. That is very, very, very sad. I don't know where the rest of that story goes. But just give me the stuff, man. Just don't talk my ear off with this depressing stuff. I've already got a cat that has diabetes. I don't need to know all your other crap that's going on here. All right, let's go put this thing inside the car. Now we need to grab... We're gonna need to grab our, whoa. Okay, yep, just stay right there. Don't you go anywhere. We need to go ahead and grab that sofa. Now, I think that the sofa, if I remember correctly, is over at the dump site? All right, we're gonna do something a little bit different today. I think that I'm gonna go over here and take this van home. Haven't driven the van in a long time, but the other thing is, too, if we can get the seat, if we can get the bench... The van is gonna be the thing that we're gonna wanna put it in. Cause it's got much more space. And quite frankly, the back seat of this thing is crap. So the van is much, much better. Let's get out of here. Now I gotta open this, pop this up right here. Very good. What the fuck? Okay. All right. Everyone calm down. Gray just fell through the world. What is with the world? It's been like 50 episodes since I've fallen through the world. Son of a bitch. Okay, let's try this again. Only this time with less world breaking. Can we not fall through the universe? Okay, you know what? I'm not going back. I'm not going in the back of the vehicle. So my freaking bag opened up, as it often does when I die horribly. Well, not die, but when I transverse time and space. So now I have to grab all the crap over here, as I often do, instead of having it inside of the nice, tidy little bag, and I've got to put it inside of the van. Come here, sugar. You boys ever played the yeast throwing minigame? Look at that. right inside. I think it actually went in one side of the van and out the other. Hold on here. Right there. There we go. Yes. The yeast throwing mini game. How many yeasts can you get inside of the passenger portion of the van? Look at this, man. I'm doing better at this than I am at throwing water on the freaking sauna. All right. We got some sugar. We got some yeast. We'll go ahead and grab this over here because we do need a case of beer inside of the van because you never know when we're going to end up getting thirsty. How much, kind of curious, how much gas is in this thing? It's been a long time. We're doing okay. We could probably put a couple of gallons of diesel in here, though. Oh, yeah. It's been so long. I've forgotten how well this thing drives. And by how well, I mean how freaking terrible. Let's go over here and grab a couple of gallons of diesel real quick before this place shuts down. I don't know what time it is right now. I wonder if driving this thing is like a death sentence still. Because every once in a while, if you remember, I think my very... All right, there goes the alcohol. I think my very first death in this game came from this. When I had like gotten into it, I turned the ignition and then it spontaneously exploded my body straight through the freaking windshield. You guys remember that? Let's go take our little thingy off here. There we go. I'm not gonna lie. I'm very excited for my space van, or as the developer calls it, my spase van. I think it was a spase? Yes, spase van. If it's real and it's not like an April Fool's thing, it looked like it was gonna be virtual reality my summer car in space. Oh, Lord. How I would enjoy that. Oh, this is fantastic. This is much different than trying to fill up the crapmobile. Gotta spend our poop money, though. You boys know, some people, you know, hitmen have blood money, all right? Drug dealers have drug money. We have poop money because that's where all of our cash comes from. Grabbing crap, hauling it out of people's septic tanks, and then getting sweet, sweet marks for it. Okay, how much do I owe you? 109 bucks? No big deal. Let's go back inside of our van and see if we can grab the freaking seat of power. Driving inside the van, cracking open beers. Let me tell you something, boys. This brings back some memories. Some painful, painful memories. Oh, there goes the freaking bus. Oh, I'm glad to see that he drives as poorly as I do. Right off the road there. Very good. But yeah, you boys looking forward to my spossy van? Feel free to let me know in the comment section below. Yes, there it is. Oh, I'm so glad to see that I left a case of beer over here too. I told you, I got beer all over this place, man. I got beer all over this map. What is this over here? Is this a thing of milk? Oh, well, that's good. Why don't we go ahead and slobber that down real fast? We had a little bit of hunger anyway. Gonna open this up. Toss that over there. Grab this right here. I don't wanna sleep. I wanna grab it. There we go. And right over here, we've got plenty of space inside of the van for this. Plenty of space. Just gotta kinda shuffle our way in. Right there. Now we can sleep in the van if we needed to. Alright. Is there anything else around here that we need? Oh, you know what? Empty plastic can. This is Kilju fodder right here, boys. Put that in there. Uh-oh. The dogs are barking. That means that nighttime is upon us. We better get home because Lord knows what sort of crazy chupacabra stuff will be trying to eat us. Oh, hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold the phone. I just saw something. Just saw something very important. Look at this, boys. We're getting wings. Plus, it's another piece of our car. I told you. Stuff's everywhere. You never know. You never know. Go ahead, put that right in there. Excellent. I've been getting a lot of tweets from people that have just started to get into my summer car. And they've mentioned pain and the agony of dying on permadeath when you almost have your engine built. Let me tell you something, boys. I know exactly what you're going through. I have felt the exact same pain. I've had days. There was supposed to be a quiet afternoon. Driving to the store in my summer car. No big deal, right? No big deal. When all of a sudden, the thump-thump bastard drives his vehicle right up my anus, causing my colon to go flying out of my throat. And then, only then, did I realize the true purpose of this game. This game was made for masochists. And so if you play this game and you derive any level of pleasure from it, understand that you are one of us. You are, in fact, a horrible, horrible masochist. I'll tell you what dying to the thump thump car does. It makes you constantly be wary of your freaking rearview mirror. That's what it does. My eyes are always on it. I shouldn't have to live in fear like this. It shouldn't be a big deal, but it is, because it's my summer car, and it doesn't want you to survive. It doesn't want you to continue to live. It wants to kill you as many ways as possible. And you know what else it does? It makes me drive like Miss Daisy, because I've had far too many instances where I've driven way past my capabilities. And all that did was cause me to go flying into one of these many ravines and break my neck. And then it was back to plan, back to the starting point. Back, no plan B. Plan B was survive. Plan A was get the episode done without any hitches. And that never happens. That never happens in my summer car. The other thing that it causes you to do, hold on here, is look both ways when you come up to the train tracks. Because Lord knows, that train will snipe your ass in a heartbeat. You won't even know. The next thing you'll see is the newspaper flying at you with that damn music playing, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, saying, young man dead in car crash, or young man dead in plane crash, or young man dead in train crash, or young man's bladder explodes. Any one of those things is a real possibility in my summer car. And we are home, baby. One piece, too. That's a good day. I'm gonna tell you something. Whenever you get home, well, let me turn these lights out so I don't kill our freaking battery. Whenever you get home without dying in my summer car, that right there is a good day. Always put your parking brake on, boys. So, first things first, we gotta get this set up just the way you boys said to. So we're gonna grab the bucket, all right, hold on now. We're gonna grab the bucket, we're gonna bring the bucket out here, this way I don't do this the hard way, and we're gonna grab 6 sugars, all right? So, 1, here we go, I'm gonna count them out, just like freaking Sesame Street here, so I don't screw this up. 2, that's a lot of freaking sugar for some Kilju, I'm gonna tell you what. Hold on now, there we go, a little bit of finished headbutting. 3, come on now, do this for Gray. There we go. 4. And, oh, Jesus. Come on, baby. Just one time. There we go. 5. That was 5, right? That was... I'm counting out loud and I forgot. Yeah, that was 5. And 6. Okay. So that's 6. And now 1 yeast. 1 yeast. Bloop. Okay. Now that we have all this, they said fill it up to the brim with water. So let's go ahead and we're going to go into the bathroom for this because bathroom water should be just fine. Plus, we get to, oh, don't knock this over. Plus, we get to say hi to the Homo Hyperclean. Hello, Homo Hyperclean. Is that, hold on a second. Is that like a gingerbread man? No, I think that's just like a little cleany spot or something like that. For a minute there, it almost looked like a friggin' gingerbread man. My brain's playing tricks on me. All right, put that right over there. Now, we have to fill, come here. There we go. We have to fill this up. Fill it up to the tippy-tippy top. Now, I don't know, boys, if you can overfill this or what. There we go. Okay, so it just changed. Hopefully, it doesn't all freaking spill out. Oh, my urine's getting all over the place. Hold on. There we go. I'll just kind of do this over here for right now. Oh, it's because I'm drinking the water. Oh, it's because I was too close to the water. See how this crap happens, boys? Oh, no, I'm peeing in the shower. Although, I don't think that this is that bad. I don't think that this is the worst party foul that you can possibly have. I do not want to piss inside of the Kilju, though. Oh, that would ruin a batch quicker than anything else. Come on, come on. Get that piss out of there. God, what is it, like the 100-year piss or something like that? Come on, man. Get done. Squeeze out the last few drops. Squeeze it. Squeeze. Squeeze. There we go. Okay. We're done. And are we full? No, it's still going up. Look, I think it's still going up. Hold on, let me zoom in here. No, it's not going. No. Yeah, my eyes aren't playing tricks on me. It's not going up anymore. Okay. So we're done. Boom. We've got what I believe from you guys now is the ultimate Kilju recipe, supposedly. Grab this. Hold on now. Grab this. Put this right on. Boop. There. Okay. Now. There we go. Okay, good. We heard the glug, glug, glug. Okay. So now we just have to leave this alone for several days, and then we'll be back to try and sell it. Okay, here we go. Through the magic of science, this should be done. Here we go. We should have the perfect Kilju. Oh, crap. Hold on. Like, if there was yeast in here, it didn't, like, teleport through the Kilju, did it? I freaking hope not. All right, here we go. Let's go ahead and... Oh, no. We have a bunch of Kilju already in all here, in all these areas. Oh, but this is just juice. Okay, good. So we can go ahead and drink this. This is going to be the test. This is going to be the test Kilju jug. So where'd it go? Where did we throw it? Oh, there it is. Okay, good. So this is going to be the test one. We're going to put some Kilju in here, and we're going to try and sell it to the drunk guy, because he is the barometer for appropriate Kilju drinkiness. Okay, so there we go. I think we filled it up. I have no idea. Nope, we sure didn't. Okay, let's try this again. Oh my god. Stop teleporting through the world. There we go. Okay, boom. I'm pretty sure that is a fill, right? Yes? Yes. Okay, good. So this is the one. We got freaking Kilju all over the place, so I don't want to lose this. Okay, put that down there. Open this up. All right, boys. You guys gave me this recipe. This is what it all comes down to right here. This is for all the marbles right now. Let me go ahead and put that over there. And put this right over. Oh, right there. Nope, don't you fall over now. I'll strap you into a freaking seatbelt if I have to. Oh, we have an extra cannon or extra plastic in there. I'm gonna throw that over there for right now. Okay, let's head over to the drunk guy's house and see what he has to say about this. All right, boys, we're here. Let me just go a little bit off-road right about now. We are here. All right, you drunken scumbag. You have told me that my Kilju tastes like hammered piss for the last time. Now, with all of YouTube behind me, you will taste the greatest Kilju your giblets have ever known. Drink it. Drink the sugar wine, you dirty whore. Drink it. Yes. Yeah, tip it back. Oh, I think he likes it, boys. What's he say? Very good sugar wine. It's strong as hell. I pay good for this. Yes. Yes. Give me that money. Give me that money. Ooh, give me that money. Oh, man, we made marks for the first time. We made perfect Kilju. It's strong as hell, and we're gonna finally be friends with this guy. Now we're gonna be able to get hammered together, and that means that we have a new way to make big money. 170 some odd marks, baby. Every bottle, and I don't know how many bottles our thing makes, but it makes, I would assume, quite a bit. I didn't really see how far it went down, but guys, I couldn't have done this without you. So now we are the Kilju Masters, and we can make big cash and get hammered and make our pancreas, wait, not the pancreas, make our liver explode. That's the correct organ. Anyway, guys, we don't have time to hit ourselves on the couch, unfortunately. We'll do that next time. Until then, hope you enjoyed this episode. Stay foxy and much love.